Hello. Today I'd like to show you how to do a mitered border. So often when we put a quilt together, we put the sides on first maybe, and then we do a straight piece across the top and the bottom so that you've kind of got this square join at the corners. So I thought I'd show you this time how to do a mitre. A mitre is where it's joined diagonally coming from the point of the quilt out through the border. So I'm going to show you, you have to imagine that this fun piece of fabric is my quilt, which it will be a little quilt. So if it was a pieced quilt, applique, whatever your quilt is, and you want to put mitered borders on, this is how you could go about doing that. So what you need to know is you need to know your quilt size. So you need your width and your length of your quilt. And you need to know what your finished or your border size is going to be, how wide you're going to cut your border strips. So I'm just showing you with one border. If you're doing it with a couple of borders, it's ever so slightly differently done. So initially, I'm going to measure my width of my quilt and my border, and I know that my border is going to be, I've cut my border strips at 3 inches. So my quilt is about 16 inches. My borders are about 3 inches each side, so I have to allow for that, because you have to cut your borders the full length of the border, the finished border. So it's got to include the side borders as well. So if I say that that's 16 plus 3 plus 3, so that's 16 plus 6, so that's going to be about 22 inches. Plus you add on another couple of inches that just allow a little bit of room for movement and for seams and things. So you might cut your piece of fabric 24 or 25 inches. So it's your fabric width, your border width twice, plus a couple of inches spare is how you would work out the length to cut your borders. Because you need to pretty much have them fairly well cut. They are going to be trimmed just a little bit, but that's pretty much how you do it. So again, you need to have the length of your quilt. In this case, my quilt is just ever so slightly longer. It's 1 inch longer than my width. So I'm going to have the same border because I've got equal borders all the way around the edge. And I'm going to have my length, which is going to be 17 inches plus 3 inches plus 3 inches. Plus a couple of spare. So that's going to end up being, where did we get to? 17, 20, 23, 20, 25, 26 inches maybe, that I will need to cut the length of my borders. So I've done one corner here, and I'm going to do this opposite corner to show you how to do the corner. It will be very helpful if on your sewing machine you have a quarter inch foot, not essential though, but certainly helpful. So in order to do this, you need to mark the center of your side or top, bottom, whatever it is of your quilt, the edge that you're working on, probably just with a pin is sufficient. And you need to do the same thing on your border strip. So this is hopefully the correct border strip that I've got here. And I'm going to pop this up here. So when I put this on here, so if we take that piece out of your vision, I'm going to pin it right sides together. And I'm going to pin my center pin because I've also marked the center of my border strip with a pin so that I can match the two markings. And then I want to put a pin in, and I can pop the pin through both pieces of fabric a quarter of an inch back from my edge, because we're going to start and stop sewing a quarter of an inch in. You don't want to go right over the edge on this one. This requires you to be just a little bit careful at the corners. So we want to come in a quarter of an inch at both ends so that we're marking the finished seam size, because that's where we're going to sew. And then I'm going to go to the sewing machine. So if you happen to have a quarter inch foot, something like the one I've got here, and I'll maybe take this off and just show you if you can see this. So this foot is designed that my needle goes right in the middle of the two little feet, and the edge of the foot is quarter of an inch away from where the needle goes, so that I can get a quarter of an inch seam allowance either side, depending on which way I'm sewing. It also has some little grooves along the side of the foot. So this one here is where the needle goes, the middle one. There's three grooves. This one here is quarter of an inch away from that, and this one's quarter of an inch away from the middle one. So they're all in, everything's in quarter inch, basically. So I'm going to use this foot and just show you how I can use those markings to help me. Now, if you don't have one of these feet, you can use your pins to help guide you, or some other form of marking that you prefer. So what I'm going to do is have it up this way, because I want to start and stop a quarter of an inch from my end. So to that end, I'm going to take that pin out because that's just going to annoy me. I know it's sitting in the right place because I had it held there till I got to the machine. And I'm now going to line up the back quarter inch marking, so the one that's quarter of an inch behind where the needle goes down. So I hope that's clear for you. So that we're going to start sewing quarter of an inch in from where that little groove is. This next groove here is the quarter of an inch in from that edge. So I'm going to start there, and I'm going to do a little back stitch, and I'm going to continue on then with my seam all the way to the other end. Even I get to use pins occasionally. So I'm sailing up to this other end, and the same thing now, I'm going to stop sewing when this little groove that's in front of the needle, as I look at it, gets to the end of my fabric, so that I'm stopping sewing quarter of an inch before the end. So that's that bit there. So I've got a quarter of an inch seam allowance showing at that end and a quarter of an inch at that end. So that's one edge done already. Oh, we're getting on with this fine. Now my other border I've got ready here. And again, I've already marked my halfway point with a pin on my quilt top. And I've marked my halfway point with a pin on my border. So I'm going to pop that together at the centres so that everything sits nice in the middle. And I'm going to again turn this over because it's easier with that quarter inch foot to see these markings or see the edge of the fabric from this side. And put another pin here. So I can pop a pin in. You can put more pins than this in, and of course, if you prefer to, at that point where we're going to stop there. But we are going to be using the markings on the foot to help guide us as well. So I'll come back and sew this seam as well. So the same thing, line up that edge of your quilt top with that marking behind where you're sewing. A little back stitch. A little back stitch is quite helpful because you don't want this seam to start unraveling. And when you get to this corner, you've already got something going on here, so you've got to be a little bit more careful. And just keep this out of your way a little bit. So the piece that we'd sewn on previously is sitting there, but just let it fold down so that when you get up to it with this quarter inch marking, that you can stop in the right place. And it should pretty much meet exactly where you stopped and started on your previous line of sewing. Hopefully it will meet. And so, we are having fun now. So now I'm going to bring the iron over. And I'm just going to press my seams. I like to press my seams into the borders. So I'll just particularly do up where the corner is rather than the whole seam just at the moment. But you can do the whole seam, that's fine. Because you want these things to sit as straight as you can get them. So now we're going to work out how to do that join. So relatively simple. You've got your two borders, so you want to fold this out now so that you're laying your two borders right sides together so that your quilt top will fold right through that corner. Because we've pressed our seams to come this way. If that corner is pressed down, it's a little bit fiddly watching this, but if you were to turn your seams over and let that corner come through, that will sit quite nicely. If you can keep these border edges straight, and that's on a nice diagonal. Now, a lot of cutting boards can be quite helpful at this stage because they have these mitre marks. So a mitre is going diagonally through a square, like a whatever the angle is. I'm sure I know what it is. So I'm going to, as long as everything's sitting nice and straight, so this edge here, I'm going to line up straight with one of the lines on my board, and this mitre, this corner, because I've folded it so that it's sitting, because these are sitting together, you'll get a nice diagonal line going through there. So you can line that up with your board, line this line up with your board, and you should find that that works if everything's sitting nice and level and all things working well together. And we'll find our ruler. So I've got my straight line along here, I've got my diagonal line along here, everything is looking like it's sitting pretty well to me. So that line that's now following that diagonal line, because it comes out the other side on this board, I'll just bring this back a bit, I'm going to draw from my stitching point, following this line, right through there. I'm just going to draw myself a diagonal line there. And I'm going to pop a pin in that, or a couple if you like. These edges should still be sitting together nicely. Back to here. Because what we're going to do now is fold these little seam allowances that we've carefully pressed into the seam back on themselves, because we want to start stitching right at that point where we stopped stitching before. This probably looks a little bit harder than it really is. When you're actually doing it, you'll understand it's not so bad, because we're now going to stitch along this line that we've just drawn. So make sure that those two seam allowances are sitting back into the quilt. And we're going to take that to the sewing machine and start stitching at the same point that we'd stopped and started when we were adding the borders. So pop that in there. Again, I find it quite helpful to do a little back stitch at this stage. Take the pins out as you go. This is where we are really trusting that things are working well. Done that nice diagonal seam, so everything kind of starts and stops at this one pivotal point, and your fabrics are sitting, currently your seam is sitting towards the quilt, but we will be pressing them back into the border shortly. So now you want to have a quick check to make sure that that corner is looking good, and I think that that's looking pretty good to me. I've got a nice point coming up there. So what I'm now going to do is flip that over again. I'm just going to trim off this excess that we didn't need of this border with my cutter here. So quarter of an inch away from your seam allowance. So line up a quarter of an inch in from your ruler along the seam line that you've sewn and just trim that away. And now the other thing I want to do, just to help it sit nicely, because there's quite a lot of bulk going on at this corner here, before we do the pressing, is where this corner comes in, just on that border fabric, so in my case the red fabric, just snip in towards that sewing line. Don't snip your stitching on both of those bits. And what that will help it do is sit nicely when we press it, so that we get a nicer corner. So I'll bring the iron over now. So we're wanting that to sit out nicely. So we'll press from this side. And we're going to press this seam open. It'll sit nicer as a mitre. And because we've just snipped those corners, if you just press that seam allowance up into there, and then when we want to press this one over, because we're going to press this back into the border now, you'll find that just maybe you may just have to fiddle just a little bit of there, but because we've snipped that, that can overlap into that corner rather than being another little bunchy fold, and that should sit quite nicely into that corner there for you. So we'll turn that over to the right side, and there we have quite an acceptable mitre join on our border for our quilt. So I've done the two opposite sides now, And I think that that's quite nice. Sometimes you want a mitre, and I'll show you an example in a minute of one that I've used. If you're going to do these, obviously you're going to do all four of your corners at some stage. It's exactly the same technique that we've used. You sew up to the quarter of an inch before the end so that your seams meet, you'll fold it over, and you'll do your diagonal line and seam and trim it, snip the little corners, fold it out and press. So on all four corners, the technique is just the same. And I'll just show you now a little quilt that I've made. It's a table runner that I've actually done a scalloped edge. And that would be one reason why you might want to do a mitre, because you've got a different sort of edging and the mitre just sort of sits better, although often it wouldn't show. This one here, I've made this table runner, and I've wanted it to kind of follow out into the border because I've come out to a point on the corners. So my borders here, which are not easy to see because it's all white, are actually mitered on the join of all the corners. So that's an example. There's lots of other reasons. It might be a color change, it might be just part of the design you're doing. You might just prefer miters. Not everybody likes that squared off edge to the corners of their quilts. So there's an example of where you might use a miter and how you might do that miter. So hopefully that will help some of you wanting to do some miters. If you're using more than one border that you want to mitre, I'm going to do another video showing that as well. So enjoy those mitres.